morning. This is time for our Wednesday midweek service. Today is the 16th of September 2020. As always, it is such a privilege for us to share the Word of God with you. So this morning, I want to talk about endurance. I was thinking in this week, you know, as Christians, what is the most difficult thing for us to do as Christians? And sometimes it is for us just to persevere. Sometimes we are in circumstances that's not ideal. We are facing certain circumstances or some challenges that we have in our lives, and there just seems to be no immediate outcome, and we have to grind it out a little bit in our faith walk with the Lord, trusting the Lord, holding on, sometimes suffering long, sometimes exercising that famous fruit of the Spirit, patience, love, and it's not easy. That is the one thing in Christianity that sometimes is a challenge to us. We live in a society that has immediate answers. We want immediate things happening in our lives. A lot of things in this life through technology is immediate. And sometimes God doesn't work immediately. Sometimes He does. But when we trust the Lord, when we hold on to the promises of the Lord, we have to grind it out. We have to sometimes just sit. I love planting trees. Some of the trees I plant, I will not probably enjoy its shade, because they are very slow growers. And often when we sow seed, we do not just sow seed for ourselves, but also for the future generation. And therefore, we are patient with certain things in life. Thinking about the scripture in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, also since we are surrounded by so great cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him who endured such hostility from sinners against himself, lest you become weary and discouraged in your souls. You have not yet resisted to bloodshed, striving against sin, and you have forgotten the exhortation which speaks to you as sons. My son, do not despise the chastening of the Lord, nor be discouraged when you are rebuked by him. The principle of holding on to the promises of God and running the race with endurance. In order for us to have endurance, if we're running a race, for instance, we need the stamina to endure. And as Christians, we need the stamina given to us by the Holy Spirit to endure. Sometimes in life, things just don't go quickly. I often look at teachers, and as teachers, we sow our livelihood into children's lives. But many of the seed that you have sown, you will never see the fruitfulness of it. So it's nice as a teacher when an adult comes to them and say, you were my teacher in primary school, high school, and I just want to thank you for the great input that you had in my life. And then sometimes we get those little small reward systems, which is really boosting us and telling us that we're doing the right thing. And but as Christians, often when we run a race of endurance, it is just holding on. It means that things are not really changing around us right now. We're not on a mountaintop, nor are we in a valley. We're just climbing this mountain. And for a lot of Christians, it's not easy climbing that mountain. Especially when we get isolated, one of the tactics of the enemy is to isolate us and make us feel that we are running this race alone, that we are fighting this battle alone. And there are some scriptures, if we use them out of context, which is also not helpful to us, that each one must work out their own salvation with fear and trembling. It is true that we as believers must take stock of our own spiritual lives. We are responsible for our spiritual lives, but we are also part of a greater body. And the Lord has anointed and gifted the body to encourage us, to help us, to strengthen us, to teach us, so that we can run this race with endurance. The secret of endurance does not lie in my physical strength. What does the promise of the Lord say? In Isaiah it says, he who waits upon the Lord shall receive new strength. So the secret of having strength and having stamina to run this spiritual race comes from the indwelling Spirit of the Lord, comes from the Lord's grace upon our lives and the inward working of God's Holy Spirit in our lives. But as Christians, we just cannot give up. Sometimes we look at circumstances and we become desperate. And you know the scripture that says, I lift my eyes to the hills, where shall my help come from? So often we come to that place where we feel that I'm desperate right now. I don't know where my help is going to come from. I don't know how we're going to go through this. But as a confessing, spirit-filled Christian, how many times in your life have you looked back and realized, although things went difficult, although things were hard sometimes, the Lord has always been faithful. The Lord has always shown his compassion to us and his wisdom to us. The challenge of our Christianity is, and I talk about this a lot, is the ability to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to us. Even if God speaks to us through people, I would prefer God not speaking through people to me all the time. I need to hear God's voice so that I can verify what I hear, what I read, what information has been deposited to me to keep my own spiritual life safe. There's a lot of destructive doctrines, and we cannot be so proud as to think that everything we think out is holy and pure. The scripture teaches us that there's a way that seems right unto man, but unto God, it's an abomination. You know, we sometimes think that we do right, but when the Lord comes and says, but that's not what I want you to do, that happens in our spiritual lives. But the thing about endurance is, endurance is something that comes from an inner strength, which comes from a little bit of discipline in our spiritual lives to hold on to Jesus, to look into the Word, and to allow the Holy Spirit to teach us things. There's also another portion of scripture I would like to share with you here, out of 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17. It says, for this reason I have sent Timothy to you, who is my beloved and faithful son in the Lord, who will remind you of my ways in Christ as I teach everywhere in every church. So Paul is very confident in his understanding of the word, and he uses it as a template and an example for those whom he disciples and those over whom he exercises authority as an apostle. And he says, look at my example, look at my life, or rather, this is a tried and tested doctrine. It works. There's a lot of Christians that hold on to stuff. It doesn't work. People don't know whether their prayer life works effectively. People don't know whether what they believe works perfectly. People don't know whether their faith is enough. There's so many things, and there's so many challenges in our spiritual lives that can make us unsure. So here we have Paul that understands these processes, understands his responsibility, and he sends Timothy because the church needed encouragement. And sometimes in running this race of endurance, we need somebody to run with us. We need somebody to encourage us while we run. Now, that people never take the place of the Lord or take the place of the Holy Spirit. But yet the Lord has given the family of God for us as well to strengthen us, to encourage us. I mean, Ephesians 4 verse 11 says to us that the Lord has given the fivefold ministry for the equipping of the saints, for the work of the gospel. The Lord has given gifts to men for the purpose of encouraging men. So I really want to challenge those of you with gifts to use those gifts to encourage the church. Use those gifts to encourage your brothers and sisters in running the race, this race of faith that we're running, so that we don't become weary, so that we don't become tired of running this race and become despondent and discouraged. The Lord is not slack concerning his promises. The Lord will fulfill his promises in his word to us. The promises of the Lord is that he will never leave us and he will never forsake us. And it's important as a child of God that we experience the closeness of the Holy Spirit and the faithfulness of the Father's love. Because that is what encourages our spirit. That is what lifts our spirit when the presence of God comes into our personal lives. So that's why we spend time in the Word. That's why we spend time in prayer, speaking to God. I said to the church on Sunday, we don't soak anymore. It's amazing that when you soak in the presence of the Lord and you wait on the Lord, how many answers the Lord gives us. There's so many things that we want to know. There's so many areas that we want God to work in. And the Lord is really ready to speak to us, and the Lord is always ready to answer us, but we're not available. We don't make time to wait on the Spirit of the Lord, for the Lord to give us instruction, for the Lord to give us wisdom. And this is my prayer, and this is my hope for you, that you will have the courage, that you will have energy, that you will have the stamina to run this race with endurance, and that you are able to to suffer long if you need to suffer long, be patient if you need to be patient, and to move when God says move. And this is the only way we will make it. The Lord is good, and the Lord will be good. He's a good Father, and the Lord will never change His character towards us. He will not change His promises towards us. He will not be slack concerning His faithfulness towards us. And this is my prayer and my hope for you. So let us just pray together. Father, I thank You that I can pray for the family of God this morning. I pray for every child of God that by the power of Your word and the presence and the faithfulness of Your Holy Spirit, Lord, that You will impart into every child of God that hope and that life, that give us the ability, Lord, to endure, to persevere, to keep on pressing through, because this life is a good life. Life is a gift from God. We thank You for this life. We thank You for every good gift. We thank You for every challenge. We give You honor and praise. Father, we love You so much. There is no other God like You. You are the lover of our soul. Your word says that no one will ever separate us from the love of God which is in Christ. Lord, You have done everything possible for us to be able to hear and see and experience Your presence. I also pray this for the church. And I thank You for Your mercy and Your grace. In Jesus' mighty precious name. Amen. Amen. The Lord bless you. Have a wonderful week.